We know atoms are made of protons, neutrons, and electrons. But what if I told you that protons and neutrons are made up of something 1,000 times smaller? In 1968, scientists at the Stanford Linear Accelerator Center discovered that protons and neutrons are composed of quarks. And one specific combination of quarks, known as quarkonium, may completely change how we think about particle physics. Before we discuss quarkonium, we must first talk about the many forms of quarks. There are six known types of quarks, which are each found in different particles. Firstly, the up quark, which is the lightest of all quarks, has a charge of plus 2/3 and makes up baryons, which are usually triquarks, such as protons and neutrons. Along with the positively charged up quarks are negatively charged down quarks with a charge of minus 1/3, which are the second component in protons and neutrons. With two up quarks and one down quark, the two plus 2/3 charges and the one minus 1/3 charge combine to form a plus 1 charge baryon, which is also known as a proton. One up quark and two down quarks combine one plus 2/3 charge and two minus 1/3 charges to form a neutrally charged baryon, which is a neutron. But up and down quarks don't just make up baryons. They are also found in certain mesons, called pions, along with up and down antiquarks. Antiquarks are like quarks, but have opposite charges. The pi plus is composed of an up quark and a down antiquark, and so the plus 2/3 and plus 1/3 charges combine to form a plus 1 charged pion. The pi zero is either an up quark, up antiquark pair, or a down quark, down antiquark pair, resulting in a neutrally charged pion. The pi minus is made of a down quark and an up antiquark, resulting in a minus 1 charged pion. Next is the strange quark, which is the third lightest of all quarks, only more massive than the up and down quarks. Strange quarks have a charge of minus 1/3, and they make up many different particles. Strange quarks make up both mesons, particles with an equal number of quarks and antiquarks, and baryons. Firstly, a kaon, also known as a k-meson, has four different forms. The k-plus contains an up quark and a strange antiquark, and so the plus 2/3 and plus 1/3 charges combine to form a plus 1 charged kaon. The k-zero contains a down quark and a strange antiquark, and the k-bar zero contains a down antiquark and a strange quark, and both are neutrally charged kaons. The K-, which is the antiparticle of the K+, contains an up antiquark and a strange quark, resulting in a minus 1 charged kaon. Strange quarks are also found in sigma baryons. The sigma plus has a composition of up up strange and a charge of plus 1. The sigma 0 has a composition of up down strange and a charge of 0. And the sigma minus has a composition of down down strange and a charge of negative 1. Strange quarks are found in other strange particles as well, such as phi mesons, which consist of a strange quark and a strange antiquark. The next flavor is known as the charm quark, which is part of the second generation of matter like the strange quark. The charm quark is found in D mesons, which have six different forms. D plus, charm anti down, with a charge of plus 1. D minus, down anti charm, with a charge of minus 1. D zero, charm anti up, and D bar zero, up anti charm, with a charge of 0, ds plus, charm anti-strange, with a charge of plus 1, and ds minus, strange anti-charm, with a charge of minus 1. Next is the bottom quark, which is about 4 times more massive than a proton. The bottom quark is contained in certain hadrons, called B mesons. There are 4 different types of B mesons, B plus, up anti-bottom, and BC plus, charm anti-bottom, with a charge of plus 1, and B0, down anti-bottom, and BS0, strange antibottom, with a charge of 0. The sixth and final quark flavor is the top quark, which is the most massive of not only the six quark flavors, but of all elementary particles. Because of the top quark's incredibly short mean lifetime of 5 times 10 to the negative 25th seconds, it does not exist long enough to form strong interactions. So you're probably wondering what quarkonium is, considering it's not any of the baryons or mesons I've mentioned. That's because quarkonium has 3 forms, each involving a heavy quark and its own antiquark. Firstly, there is charmonium, also known as a J psi meson, which consists of a charm quark and a charm antiquark. Charmonium is roughly 3 times more massive than a proton, and decays into gluons after 7.2 times 10 to the negative 21 seconds. Next, there is bottomonium, also known as an upsilon meson, which consists of a bottom quark antiquark pair. Lastly, there is taponium, also known as a theta meson, formed by a top quark and top antiquark, which is expected to not be observed in nature due to its incredibly short lifespan. While there may only be six different types of quarks, there are many other elementary particles that exist within the Standard Model, which I might talk about in another video. Quarkonium is very interesting to study because of the unstable heavy quarks it contains, helping scientists further observe both their properties and strong force interactions. Perhaps there are more elementary particles to be discovered, but until then, we can only guess from a selection of infinite possibilities. Thanks for watching. Like and subscribe.